So I saw a very interesting video on social media actually. The assistant actually sent me this video a little bit earlier on. Thought it was quite an interesting one. And it is this one right here. This couple, that's a pastor and his wife. And so they were going somewhere and they got a little bit of stuck because there was a little bit of flow of water there. And A man of God arrived. A man of God arrived to the place of the place. He had a mission across, he had a ministry call on the other side. You can tell this is a very serious mission. The man of God is holding a watch. Okay, a man of God is holding a watch. But by looking at it, she's wearing sneakers and stuff, so maybe she's like, it's much easier I carry you, and then we cross over and go to the other side. I wanted to talk about this particular thing because nowadays we have a culture that loves comparing itself with other people. Not only does it compare itself, but it constantly copies and pastes from others to itself. And so you have people telling others what their relationships should look like, and you have people who have figured out that their life is it could be better somewhere else. God knows where. I've talked about these stories about divorced people who they didn't realize how much their relationship contributed to their everyday life, that when they actually end up single, it actually turns out to be a nightmare.
Single throughout the entire pandemic and go through that profound trauma all alone without some kind of support system. And I also think it's difficult that you're no one's priority. Like there aren't really people checking up on me in the same way as if you have someone to come home to. I don't have a partner. I've been single for at least almost 4 years, since November of 2019, whatever, how long that is. And it's just so difficult because you realize that you have to be your own knight in shining armor, that there's no one coming to save you, that there's no one really is there for you. Like you're alone at the end of the day. And it's so much harder to go through the ups and downs and tumultuous of life when you don't have companionship and you don't have a partner.
Not only do we need each other, you must cater yourself particularly to yours. This copy and paste mentality of wanting to copy what you saw my neighbor what and then put it back into your thing, it actually causes distraction. Okay, because now we just have people that are just seeing what is the Joneses look like, and then they take that, copy that to bring it into their family. Even in the advices that they take advices from people who are walking a different journey in life than them. They take different advices from different people, try to patch it up, advices that could not fit into one person's life. I remember seeing a video, 2021, very discouraging video.
I've been divorced before. My first marriage, we made all of the mistakes. Unfortunately, he passed away.
So why did you guys get a divorce?
Because I really wanted something different. It's very unfortunate because he was the most loving, kind person. I had all the love and support that I could have ever wanted. But I think I went through a period wanting money. Like I wanted to be with someone and be at a different level. And I saw him work all of the time. it's one thing to like work and work and work from like 4 a.m. to 10 p.m. at night, day in, day out, and still have no resources. And for me to work, do the same, and just want a different life.
Emotional, damn it!
He just doesn't have the right financial status. There was nothing else. Says no, the man was very loving and very caring. But there was just this part. Financially, okay, we are doing fine. But we were not becoming millionaires anytime soon. And that alone was the reason why she left the man. This is mine. This is my husband. I'm going to carry my husband. Nothing to do with you. You know, even the pastor had to be reassured. No, don't worry. I've carried you. I'm carrying you. So relax yourself. There's this tendency of copy and paste. Copy different advice. Copy this small little advice here. Copy this small little advice. And then at the end of the day, it's a state of confusion, which no one meets that standard. Even you, who's giving that standard, does not meet that standard. A standard. No, you must have a house, must have a car. But you yourself, you don't have a house, you don't have a car. Let alone do you have a job. How do you want? It's this unrealistic. And what it does is it wastes your time. Now, if you're okay with wasting your time, it's fine. Okay? Yeah, we must remind people, you know, you want to waste your time, it's fine. Some of us actually realize the need to build a proper relationship with someone. And so, I'm not going to be busy copying and pasting, just take what, you see, be like this woman, carry thy husband, carry your situation. Instead of copying and pasting, I thought this video was a reminder. People nowadays have a tendency, because social media gives us access into other people's lives. People have now taken that to duplicate that and want that in their life. They would discredit honest people in their honest partners. They would discredit honest partners in choosing to something that's not there. In choosing to a fictional idea. All they do is waste their own time. But hey, no, we can't stop them from wasting their own time. You know, if a person wants to waste their own time, then go ahead. You know, is a moment when that person was single, they could have vowed, hey, she can't wait to get out of this situation. Then when they do get out, they can't wait to abandon. They can't wait to abandon it and then become something else. You know, we are, us as humans, we are very unsatisfied beings, constantly searching, you know. But it comes a point where of maturity where one must see, this is mine. You see, this is my situation. Let me carry mine. That comes with maturity. You know, the pretty girls, they constantly think that prettiness is going to last them an entire lifetime. So, without having realized that you don't have that much time. People think time wastes. You know, like time is on a pause and it's going to wait for you to make a decision. No, time keeps moving. Even if you fail to make a right decision now, you don't get another chance. Time for making decision comes and we fail to make those decisions. It's because when the time arrived, you should have been matured enough to make the decision. But you were backwards, busy copying and pasting. You were trying to fit. Does it fit Oprah Winfrey's idea of relationship, forgetting that Oprah Winfrey is not married? It's advice. You are trying to still copy and paste all these ideas. You are forgetting the one that's in front of you. And as a result of that, life does not wait for you, because you should have been matured to make the decision when it popped up. There's a lot of people that are like that. It will take them forever to realize you should have made the decision there. It's Ricky, just a reminder. And I'll see you later on. Y'all have a good one.